yeah.
I want to save this one.
Reflections on the powerful of the something curtain. Jean.
Alone in the dark. Start off with a toad.
Pick it.
So, your uncle, what's wrong with him?
He's possessed.
As in the devil?
Cap?
Something like that. He says a dark man is following him, watching him at all times.
Ooh, spicy.
What do you make of it?
It's nonsense, of course. But I'd be lying if I said it didn't bother me. You see, it runs in my family.
Possession.
So is it really nonsense?
No, detective. Deteriorating melancholy. Practically every member of the Harwood family is driven mad before they grow old.
Looks like y'all might be cursed. History of slavery foreshadowing.
But Jeremy didn't kill himself. Is that why he's at the setup?
Despite being convinced that he is truly possessed, he decided to put his last chips on Dr. Gray and his psychoanalysis. Figuring he might stumble upon some cure.
You mentioned a letter.
I received a disturbing letter from Jeremy accusing the staff and all the other patients of being involved in some cult. And now they are also out to get him.
Could it be real? Or is it all just in his head?
It's a story he tells himself, Mr. Carnby. Anything to avoid the truth.
Which is?
That we're all terribly insignificant. That people mean so very little to one another. That there is no one out to get Jeremy Harwood because he isn't worth getting.
Here we are.
My uncle's not well, Mr. Carnby. I want to make sure he's all right.
Then what's my part in this? You couldn't get a cab?
I just wouldn't feel safe going alone.
We'll see.
Did you bring a gun?
Yeah.
Hell yeah.
You think it'll actually come to that?
No. But you might need to wave it around depending on how agreeable the staff will be.
What exactly are we gonna do when we find Jeremy?
I don't know. Let's just find him first.
So we're gonna go with this fine young fellow. AKA Stranger Things. Cop.
Hello? Hello?
Looks abandoned.
It can't be. There has to be someone around.
Wait here. I'll go around back.
Chapter 1. Oh, no title? Damn. All right, whatever. Oh, as long as we understand how stick talk works, we're good. We're good shit. I guess I don't pick that up. Yeah, we got a little mechanic out here fixing on cars, you know? Gotta keep the deuce and the quarter running. Damn, it's dark as fuck. I may have to adjust it. Oh, it's just a glare. Never mind. Oh, okay. Just give me the light.
I know what we got here.
Ah, finally. Of course. All right. Strange that Y is a crouch button, but whatever, man. I'm just here for content purposes. What is this? Oh, we can't forget that. It's that stick top. Nice little garden, you know what I'm saying? Now who might this be? That's a sprained ankle. God is holding a bowl. Wait. He's holding a... Looks like something to pour water in. I'll think of it in a minute. It's not Aphrodite. Whoa. Sometimes that stick is a great tree. Sense a gateway close by.
Huh? What?
Housekeeper's key. They like to leave keys laying around. I'm assuming the crime element is non-existence. Obviously, we don't go through that door. Nor did the option appear. I advance the story. FBI, open up. I see they try to take a little bit of Resident Evil. You know, tidbit. Especially with the way they open up different damn doors. At least they took it from Resident Evil 2.
Don't mind if I do.
Whiskey in a bottle now. Hands in the sky. Come on, what the fuck? Did that thing glitch? Whoa, did that thing just... No, you know what? This isn't officially a ghost story yet. At least not yet. Is that a rat? Oh my God. Poor people.
Every day your silence weighs a little heavier. It's been a difficult year for everyone, and many have lost all hope. I read in the papers about people suffering. Pictures of dust-covered landscapes without a drop of water. I wish I knew if you were still tending the earth or if you had turned your back against us. I have started to look for help elsewhere. I pray you will tell me if I'm going down a path that you find disagreeable. With help from Batiste and Charlotte, I've found comfort in the practice of the voodoo. I have long been skeptical of that Caribbean cult, but it's been of good use to me. It seems
all harmless
in my book.
You found some shit that works.
I see some words dreamt up by the Creoles, and I carry around a small pocket of gri-gri. Nothing of this is mentioned in the Bible, of course, but the French Quarter priestess tells me it's all connected. She says the Christian God is just one more perspective on the creator of things. That's what I like to think, but the other way around. That the spirits of her faith are just aspects of you, our Heavenly Father.
I don't know about that. I am so grateful
for the words you gave Mr. Hartwood. We will sing your praises at St. John's Eve. The world will be blessed.
I think she just told you that
because
you're Christian, so she needs you to believe that.
Only the sacrifices of the Old Testament compare to your demands. Let it be the truth. A mother of earth, wood, and dirt. A mother of a thousand young.
Mother of a thousand? Okay, that's shut nigger. What are you talking about?
Devil shoestrings, a quarter. That makes $2.75, madame.
What was that you were telling the doctor? A goat without horns. What does that mean?
Ah, you must have misheard me, madame. I said no such thing.
Please. I know I don't look like any of you, but I'm devout. I'm ready to do what it takes.
Do not be so eager to sacrifice the few things you have left, madame. Now please, leave my store.
A goat without horns?
They only told her that because she's Christian. That's the real thing. They had to phrase it like that, because otherwise they would have mentioned the seven African powers. I doubt she would Well, they converted some things of voodoo into the Catholic saints, so whatever. They could have broke that out for them, but she's obviously stupid, so that's why they had to break it down into white dummy terms. Because they made sure not to tell her about the aspect of zombies and how to reanimate a corpse in voodoo. I know they didn't mention that for damn sure. They got her carrying around a talisman. For those of you watching, that's what a gri-gri is. It's a talisman. Yeah, I guess you can say it's akin to a rosary bead, only... Well, I'm not even gonna go there. I'm not gonna be petty for no reason. Don't mind if I do. Okay. Hey, and that's crazy. They have access to plenty of animals for the religious aspect of voodoo.
What was that?
They got plenty of animals to sacrifice. You know, even though you don't necessarily need all that, at least in this era of time. I need a few of it. All you need is a few veves and know how to go into a magical trance, but you know. To each its own. Hold on. This thing just opened? There's definitely an element in here that's not. Wait, what? This door just opened by itself? Okay. I feel you. Monsieur. All right, man, come down. Anyone in here? They got a... Oh, this is a wine cellar. Monsieur Candy, streetcar ticket. I'm picking up a lot of forbidden items.
I need the key.
On the first. Oh, god damn, I just picked up. Well, no, that was the door key. Something else. So she out there probably waiting, baking in the sun, but she'll be all right. She's privileged. Open this motherfucker. Damn, this old plantation house. Shit, sure got a lot of rooms. Mm-hmm.
Please do not touch the boiler. It is working after all. While the sabotage has caused a leak, only the decorative plate has been completely ruined. Let's wait for Mr. Chance to turn up and he can take a look at the leak. Mr. Waits.
Guarantee it's a nigga fixing all this shit. Huh. Two pieces missing.
That doesn't look safe.
Wait. Broken valve. Definitely don't look safe. And I'm pretty sure. Nah, he don't. He got a stiff back. He ain't crouching. He ain't crouching underneath that steam. That's for damn sure. Oh my god, this is a labyrinth. Fuck. You know these motherfuckers is killing people. For the chick. You can't tell me these motherfuckers ain't killing people for the chick. Oh, okay, we just got a leak in. Ain't nobody cleaning this up. Dirty. Someone left a person here. Rob him. Let's see. Tampon, hot comb, nothing. No, my miss. I'm just all the motherfuckers on.
Sunday, June 22nd. I spent all day looking for Jeremy. I should have cared for the others, but I'm scared that he would do something irreversible. Cassandra is upset that I didn't give her the latest shipment of pain medication that Waits brought from the post office yesterday. I would have given it to her, but the company didn't send a new key this time around, so the box is just sitting there on my desk. They must have figured we had plenty of their gimmicky keys by now. I only remember seeing one lately. Grace was playing with it inside the grand parlor. Unless it turns up by itself, it will have to wait. I have to figure out where Jeremy is. I think Jack knew something. That dog of his found a strange rot permeating the house. She's showing us, he said. Like those blots and streaks of fetid rot was talking to him.
Mm-hmm. Spirit coming through them motherfucking rots. Letting you know something up. I need the key for this. Oh, I thought there was some bullets I can. Let me get it. Piazza key. Oh, do I remember how to get up here? I mean, get back there? Should I go upstairs? Hold. Wait. Wrong button.
Decetto.
No. Where am I at? Where's the piazza? I'm sorry. Up. No, it's the conservatory. Piazza. Oh, I have to go up. Alright. But not until my investigation. Ooh, the library.
I need the key.
Damn! These motherfuckers private? Oh. Wait. Wait, I don't have to. Wait. I don't have to go up, but it just said, you know what, never mind. I'm not even gonna. Witch's broom. cool bear. We investigate everything around here.
I need the key.
God damn. Shit, you can't tell me these motherfuckers ain't got a secret to hide. Everything needs a key? Oh, yeah. This is a murder mystery. I'm finding a bunch of dead slaves and they out there making fucking borscht off their fucking pineal gland. It's understood. That can't fool me. There's Lovecraft Company out there. Whoa. That zoom in was crazy. It's Lovecraft Company all over. It's gonna have a doctor with a bunch of random nigga parts given to the police. Oh shit, was I supposed to do that? Oh, I don't care. I don't care.
I need the key.
Motherfucker! Yeah, it's gonna have some experimental doctor experimenting with a bunch of fucking mental patients using random Negro parts to assimilate the police force. Not the police force, but if you've seen Lovecraft Country, you know what I'm talking about. The most racist police guy in had none but Negro parts just so he could use
the Great magic. Depression. President Hoover raises tariffs on over 20,000 imported goods in an act to protect American labor. Following the collapse of the Wall Street stock market on October 24 last year, American industry has suffered greatly. Thousands of companies have gone bankrupt and left a large part of the American workforce unemployed. In an attempt to turn the tide, the Smoot-Hawley Tariff Act has been signed by President Herbert Hoover. By regulating commerce with foreign countries, the government hopes to encourage the industries of the United States to compete with cheap foreign imports. Superstition on rise. New Orleans voodoo stores and spiritual mediums see increased profit during troubled times. While the market has faced hard times ever since Black Thursday of last year, voodoo doctors and snake charmers see significant rise in number of customers. With the coming Eve of St. John on the 23rd, the police expect increased cult activity around Bayou St. John, the southern shore of Lake
Pontchartrain. It's cult activity, but you got a church
voodoo
on every corner.
Voodoo rituals in that area on the Eve of St. John have a long tradition reaching back to the first snake worshippers brought as slaves from West Africa. During the 19th century, its practice was popularized by the legendary Marie Laveau, and has since been embraced by many of the Creoles and the surviving aristocracy of the French Quarter.
Good for them.
Author seeks asylum. Rumors regarding author Cassandra Beauregard making Dorsetto her home verified. Dorsetto Hospital is an old plantation building on the eastern shores of Lake Pontchartrain. While often considered an asylum for the insane, residing Dr. Elmore Lee Gray prefers to think of it as a convalescent home, a place where you can go to rest. The patient list is kept secret, but thought to include many of the black sheep of wealthy families, because at Dorsetto, treatment does not come for free. Local author Cassandra Beauregard has now been confirmed by her own admission. She's been lauded as a powerful Creole voice and written many successful books. Lately, it was reported from Hollywood that she has finished a moving picture manuscript titled Slaughter Gulch. That film is set to hit the theaters next year.
You know, fun fact, this is around the time where, if I remember correctly from the book, where...
Thanks.
Well, fucking welfare
what are you
was
doing?
Originally used for
Who
white
are
people
you?
To
Whoa,
establish
pardon me.
Some
Excuse
sort
me.
Of...
My name is Edward Garnby, private investigator.
To basically come up from
I
out
don't
of
mind
poverty.
We let ourselves inside.
Welfare programs.
I do and, mind. This is private property. You can't just barge in here.
And,
I'm sorry about all this, but
I'm looking
for
my action was originally used for
it's
the
urgent.
Italians
and
Irish.
No one was answering
white
the door.
Wouldn't hire them because
we can't hear you knocking
of their,
anymore.
Of
None
their
of
Negro
us can.
Heritage.
Who is your uncle, darling?
Jeremy. Am I right? She has that Hartwood glue, doesn't she?
That's right.
And these
I'm
are
Emily
all wealthy,
Hartwood.
Rich,
I just came
supposedly
to make sure
mentally
my uncle
ill
was
people
right.
in a treatment.
He's unavailable so. Right now. You will have to come back another day.
Unavailable? How? Is he sleeping? We can wait.
He's lost.
Don't I know
there it
him
is.
From somewhere?
Who's your man again, Miss Hotwood?
My name's Edward Carnby, private investigator.
Splendid.
Enough, all of you. Get back to your rooms. McCarthy, keep your eyes on the child. And you two, please leave immediately.
Look, we're not here to cause any trouble. Just let us see the old man, satisfy the curiosity of my client here, and we'll be off.
Jeremy has gone missing. There's no need to worry, but it might be some time before he turns up. The whole staff is looking for him.
What? He ran off?
I don't have time for any of this. Please, come back tomorrow.
He started right, dealing with ancient science.
It's upstairs, right?
Wait, you can't.
Don't worry, we'll be discreet.
In the corridor. It's the first door on your left. I'll tell Dr. Gray you're here.
Excellent.
Thank you, madam.
Hold on now. What is this? This is some interesting architecture. Everything has a missing piece. I might have to get my puzzle on. Oh, this guy's a little crabbed. He may have a little melon. No, he ain't got a melon. But he may have a little melon in him. He out here being creative. Hold on now. That looked like a. It almost looked like
every night the dark man stands opaque at the threshold of my room, counting the days until my spirit spills out of my tired shape. Only his pallid mask shelters my remaining sanity. Staring directly into the face of that demonic sultan would surely sunder time itself. Would he have looked the same to my father as he struggled for his life? Does his veiled face haunt my niece quite the same way? I wish so that I could rest my soul in that sunburnt convent of Tarawea. Would I find you there, Juan? Or Senora Pierosi? Back from the beyond. Every night I hide from him, moving from one misshapen memory to another. Scenes conjured out of fantasy and delirium. Places I struggle to even paint. I wish I understood your death, Signora. Is there anything I could do for you but bury you in that bleak necropolis? That triumphant chapel rising above the ledges and the oven vaults shall be your sepulcher, where you may rest, and I shall weep.
Oh, I ain't hear the last part. Painted tile. Hey. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Now, time to get my puzzle guide on. I'm sorry, puzzle master. All right. Now, we're going to move this here. Easy, 1, 2, 3. Hold on.
Hey,
what is this?
You know anything about this? Looks like some sort of talisman.
No, I don't. Oh, help me out here, will you?
Oh, my God. She's mostly, I don't even know if I'm going to play as both of them. I'm just going to play as the dude. She's seems like an insufferable white woman. Insufferable.
Kill the guy, throw some of this stuff out? I'd be crazy too if I had this much junk lying around.
He's obviously a wealthy painter or an artisan of sort.
Oh, wow. That's
oh,
striking.
Yeah.
I want to save this one.
Reflections on the powerful of the something curtain. Jean. Oh, yeah, that's beautiful. That was beautiful.
All right. Come on, I want to go see Dr. Gray.
The veil is lifting, Monsieur. The veil is lifting.
Come on, let's go.
Yeah, I'm coming.
Miss Hartwood.
Emily?
Another realm.
Where am I?
Sound like some Cthulhu type shit.
We both strangers in Jeremy's story.
Jeremy did this. How?
Pact with the dog man. Jeremy warned us, but we didn't think much of it.
Pact with the dark man.
I'm Detective Edward Carnby. I was hired by Jeremy's niece to find him.
Oh yeah? How much she paying you?
$150.
She's sure getting her money's worth tonight.